Good morning. Welcome to Bazaar Morning Call. I'm Lata and with me is Sonia. Well, the images we showed you are something which are going to be with us, and that may be one big reason why the Indian markets are cheerful, although the global markets are not. And that's perhaps the theme we have to tackle with today, Sonia. Global markets sulking for the second day in a row, by which I mean, of course, Wall Street. But Asia wasn't too gung-ho on Friday either. For two continuous trading sessions when Wall Street and Asia were showing risk off, and Europe, global markets showing risk off, Indian markets went ahead. We were green in, on Friday, and yesterday we were green and how? A fairly decent rally. Now the point is, how long can we continue with this divergence? And I'll just point out a couple of things that may be negative in terms of our ability to continue the divergence. One, the fall in crude prices is indicating a severe growth scare. You don't see fuel prices falling like that unless, you know, you have some worries that economic activity is falling. And yesterday, data in India showed that India's fuel consumption is falling.
Okay.
That also shows perhaps lower economic activity in India. It's something you have to take note of. And then very little institutional activity. The FII numbers, you know, even if you looked at the gross numbers, the average FII numbers are falling. In terms of intensity of activity. And of course, they were net sellers as well. So it looks like yesterday's rally and maybe even Friday's was largely on trader activity. And therefore, you begin to wonder whether, you know, we can go against global cues for so long without institutional support. If there was institutional support, they were making a conscious choice. Yes, this is a market that will not be absorbed in the global slowdown. That's different. We don't seem to see that evidence now. So I would wonder whether we will be able to continue with that kind of a rally.
Oh, absolutely. And the rally has been so ferocious, right? I mean, we've rallied about 555 points from the lows that we saw in December. So it, not even 10 days, the rally on the Nifty itself has been so, you know, hard and fast. So maybe you could see some sell-off today, the people who've sort of made those gains. And if you look at what's happened in December so far, India has outperformed a lot of its peers, whether it's the emerging market index, whether it's the S&P 500. So India, the MSCI India index is down 2.2%. But look at the others. MSCI EM is down 4%. The S&P 500, you spoke about that. It hit a fresh 2018 low yesterday. So of course, there's big underperformance over there. So let's see. The level to watch, I guess, would be the 200-day moving average. 10,759 is that level. Maybe that could provide some support if we see an opening, you know, at the lower level. Let's see. The SGX Nifty is indicating that there could be a fall. But Lata, after the kind of big rally that we've seen, what are the FNO cues indicating in terms of, you know, where perhaps some support could be found?
Well, in the first place, FII intensity has certainly fallen. You know, Nigel just pulled out this data for me. Average FII purchases in this month has been 4,800 crores. Yesterday, it was only 3,200 crores. So clearly, it's the intensity of activity is falling. But more on, you know, the way in which the longs and shorts are. Look at the short contracts. It's, you know, the number of short contracts are far more than the number of long contracts. In fact, only on Monday, they have added 5 shorts for every 1 long. So it looks like they are poised. And even if you looked at the way their you know, index options are placed, there are about 6,940 put contracts, clearly indicating that they are buying protection on the lower level. And it's not that they're going and buying calls expecting, you know, anything positive on the upside. So FII activity trends are indicating that they are, you know, placed. They're placing their bets on a fall in the market and they're buying protection. So let's wait and see. You know, if you believe these are savvy operators and therefore you read their calls. But I would also worry about the texture of the rally because it seems to be based on some kind of fiscal and a bank capital stimulus that they're working with. It's now, these are a little flimsy. For instance, loan waiver. That in itself will give a little more money for people to spend because you don't have to pay back your home, your farm loan. These things they expect will spur consumption, but these are not very sturdy, you know, indications. Yesterday you had Neelkanth Mishra telling us that he's not betting too much on consumption anyway. Even with all this, consumption is unlikely to move much. And therefore, you know, this rally, I don't think is supported by very strong fundamentals.
Okay, let's see which way things go. After a 500-point move from the lows, I guess some profit-taking is perhaps a prudent thing to do. But let's tell you what our wise experts have to say as we head into trade this morning. The FOMC is all set to start its last meeting for 2018, as we know. Andre De Silva of HSBC says there are widespread expectations of a 25 basis points Fed hike, but there could be a dovish tone to this tightening. He says there are two distinct outcomes that could signal a more dovish bias. The FOMC could reduce the number of median projections, dot plots of rate hikes in 2019 to 2 25 basis points increases, down from 3. He adds another shift may be via removing explicit forward rate hike guidances via dropping the phrase further gradual increases in the target range for the federal funds rate in the policy statement. So if these two come out, then that could indicate a dovish tone from the Fed.
Yeah, but we're not going to get it tomorrow when we come back to trade. We're only going to get day after, yeah, since it's a two-day meeting. But these are important cues that we have to watch out for. Let's get your money market views. Bhaskar Pandey of HDFC Bank says in US, the Fed is expected to hike interest rates for the last time in 2018. But the moot point is whether they're going to be more dovish, as we just pointed out. Bhaskar Pandey says the dollar index is a little elevated, but oil continues to remain subdued. Hence, he says USD INR pair might remain glued around the 71.50 pivot. Expects the range for today for the USD INR pair at 71.40 to 71.60.
And Bhaskar Pandey says as far as the Indian benchmark yields are concerned, they remain soft as inflation expectations remain subdued. He expects the 10-year benchmark bond yield to remain within the 7.43 to 7.50% range for today.